What's up, everybody? Today we are checking out Age of Mythology Retold, a remake of the classic 2002 RTS from Xbox Game Studios and World's Edge. Thank you to Xbox for sending me the code for the game on Xbox Series X over on Keymailer. The game is also available today on Game Pass on Xbox Series X, S, and on PC. So I am not a major RTS expert by any means, so this is mostly going to be my unscripted thoughts on the game as a generally new player that is not obsessed or an expert with RTS games. Now, I have obviously played a lot of the classics, such as Warcraft and Starcraft, Stronghold, Age of Empires, etc., but this is not a game that I played a lot growing up like many people. So I think this is a fresh take on the experience that I'm able to give a unique perspective, in that I am not coming at this with years and years of baggage and expectations, but rather coming at it as a new game that I have not really played a whole lot of. And I think they did a wonderful job adapting it, to be honest with you. It plays really, really well on Xbox. All of the shortcuts and button mapping are very logical. They make sense. You're watching gameplay of me doing the first mission of the campaign after the prologue of the initial campaign. I'm sorry, there's three different campaigns in the default game. There are also expansions and DLC available already, with more plans coming soon. I was really, really impressed with this game. I'm only going to show you clips from the beginning and some of the tutorial areas and whatnot. But you can see visually, it's a very, very attractive looking game. They did a great job updating the art style. The gameplay flow is very similar to the original. I went back and looked at some footage of the original to get an idea of what they changed. And obviously the UI is totally different. They've made some updates to the gameplay. One of the major changes that I saw mentioned was the fact that your god powers are now not finite. So you have a favor resource that can be increased without a cap, and your god powers are on a cooldown, so you can use them a lot more often, which is really nice. If you've ever played an RTS, this game is relatively similar to what you might be expecting, especially if you play with the Greek faction. There are Greek, Norse, Egyptian, you know, all the various different mythological cultures, along with their deities and whatever they worship and how they live their life, is captured in this game, which is really nice because each faction you pick plays very differently. There's also a tab in the main menu that allows you to learn more about the different factions and how they play, which is really fantastic. Over in the Learn column, you can learn about each of the different cultures and watch a little video that tells you about the culture and how they've adapted that particular culture's lifestyle to the game so that they all play differently, which is really nice. In my experience, it seemed like the Greek faction was your more traditional RTS faction, where you would have a city center, you would gather resources like food and wood, you would build houses and have villagers to get resources, and you would build your melee troops, your archers, your, you know, build a dock for boats, and you would get flying troops like different mythological creatures and so on and so on. And then all of the other factions actually play a little bit differently, which is nice. It's really been a while since we've had a competent and actually really appealing RTS game on consoles that doesn't dumb the experience down too much, but rather really seems to embrace and adapt what makes RTS games so popular on PC. Obviously, some of the examples that come to mind are like the Halo Wars games and the Age of Empires ports that the same studio has done. So I think seeing Age of Mythology retold on Xbox and having it play so well and look so good is really exciting, because I think this is a genre that has really missed out on the console audience for a long, long time. And I would love to see more games that embrace RTS tropes and mechanics come to consoles. And I think this game is a great entry point because it has really interesting and great storytelling in its campaigns, but then you can also play co-op against AI with friends or online multiplayer, or even different skirmishes offline solo to really practice all the different scenarios and, you know, types of skirmishes that you'll have in the game. Now, if you've played strategy games for any length of time, I'm sure watching my gameplay is a little bit painful for you. But trust that I was trying to pay attention and really learn the ropes of what I was supposed to be doing, especially in this footage of the first mission after the prologue. It has a good learning curve. It really does ease you into things, which is fantastic. I think there's a lot of information on screen at any given time, But if you just follow along with what it's telling you to do, it's actually relatively simple to learn the correct flow of building up a base and then eventually leaving your base of operations with troops and armies and, you know, going out to complete the objectives. I think that's really the flow of the game, and it does a good job of gradually introducing you to those different mechanics. One of the things that I really did appreciate is how detailed the world actually is and how detailed the troops are. You can fully rotate the camera as much as you want. You can zoom in and go really, really close down to ground level to look at your troops and really inspect them when they're doing things like battling or exploring or building different, you know, structures. I think that's something that console games really lose out on a lot of the time. Like, for example, something that comes to mind for me immediately, and I know this is a very different kind of game, but in Diablo 4, I was so frustrated that I couldn't zoom in on my character very well, and I couldn't really look at the world, which was obviously gorgeously detailed, but you couldn't get a good look at stuff. But in this game, you actually can. You can zoom all the way in just using the right stick, and it does not affect performance. It doesn't pause the game or anything weird like that. It just continues playing. You can zoom in, spin the camera around, look wherever you want. All the characters, all the buildings, the terrain, everything is, you know, wonderfully modeled in full 3D. Looks awesome, looks fantastic. I think they did a really, really nice job with this game. So I think if you have any passing interest in RTS games and you have Game Pass, you should download this and give it a try. Even if you don't have Game Pass, if you like RTS games, if you miss Age of Mythology, Age of Empires, these classic sort of RTS style of games, then I think you should give this game a try for sure. Even just to play the campaign, even if you have no interest in multiplayer, there's over 50 single player missions that are all, you know, actual storylines with cutscenes and dialogue with great voice acting. I know a lot of lore, obviously, with the different mythologies and cultures. So there's a lot of stuff to embrace here, even if you don't touch multiplayer at all whatsoever. And then if you do want to do co-op, you can. If you want to play PvP, you can. You know, there's plenty of skirmishes you can do as a solo player. You know, tons and tons of content. So I think if you have Game Pass, this is a no-brainer, even if you've never played an RTS. And if you do have interest in strategy games, then you definitely, definitely, definitely need to check this one out. So thank you once again to Xbox Game Studios for sending me the code on Keymailer. I do appreciate it. If you want to see more coverage of this game, let me know. I'm really interested in playing more of it. It's just a question of whether or not I have the bandwidth to invest more time in it. But I did play the first few hours of one of the campaigns, and I really came away impressed. I love it. I think it's fantastic, and I think a lot of people should give this game a try, even if they're not generally RTS fans. So thank you very much for watching my gameplay. I hope you learned something about Age of Mythology Retold, and if not, I hope you at least came away with a more positive impression of the game, because I think it's really worth a try. Once again, these were my unscripted thoughts on the game, so thank you for watching. My name is David Jagneaux, aka the Jaggernaut. Make sure you hit subscribe, hit the like button, drop a comment down below. Let me know if there are any particular games you want me to check out. They could be new games, could be old games, doesn't matter. I play all types of genres and platforms, so let me know what you want to see here on the channel. Thank you very much for watching.